The Mini Pop Kids are set to embark on a nationwide tour of 21 cities coast to coast. Tickets available now at the website minipopkids.com. More shows are going to be announced shortly. And with an entirely new cast and look, the Mini Pop Kids are back with their 17th series of the most famous compilation in music history. The brand new show features family-friendly versions of this year's biggest hits, including songs by Ariana Grande, Maroon 5, Bruno Mars, and more. Plus, throwback favorites that fans of all ages are going to enjoy in story tradition. This isn't just a show that they're going to be doing, its experience for the whole family. And you can find the album on the very Story KTEL Records. I love that. And I'm so happy to have Peyton and Jazzy from the group here. How are you?
Hi.
Are you missing school?
Yes.
Did you miss?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so lucky.
Yeah.
How do you manage to live both lives? How are you guys like pop stars and then go back to school the next day when teachers are asking for homework?
Well, you know, sometimes I really just ask them beforehand.
Yeah.
So I know I'm going to be off from school. So I ask for homework. You know, I got a lot.
So what do you do? Like, do you say, like, you know, Mr. Thomas, like, I'm going to Vancouver.
Whoa,
like, tomorrow.
That's actually
I'm on tour.
Name.
Really?
Yeah, that's actually what his teacher's name.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Look at me.
I'm
also, the show is also a mind reading show, too. So, like, do you have to go and sit down with the principal and the teachers and like give them your whole schedule for the year?
I don't have to do the principal. I just tell my teachers.
Of course not, because you're just like, of course. I'm like, yeah. Like, why would I need to do this? So for a lot of people that are out there that there might be parents or that there might be kids that are out there, walk me through how you were just regular kids one day, and then how do you become a Mini Pop Kid? Walk me through, like, is there an ad? Do you have an agent? Who tells you about this stuff?
I have an agent, and you're at my agent.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're both at the same agent.
You have my agent. But don't share an agent.
You're at my.
When did you first get an agent?
Six.
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, well, how old are you, Jeff?
I'm 12.
You're 12. And
I'm 11.
You? Okay, so let's work backwards. So, six. So what made you... Why were you so, what did you do that was so great that your parents said, I think you should get an agent now when you're six?
Oh, well, we were like at the Eaton Center. My dad and my sister and I were just shopping, and this lady handed out a card for an agent.
Yeah.
And we just went. And
really?
Like
you're just walking and they're saying, like, there's something about you?
Yeah. I was like, oh, but now I'm at a different agent.
Look at you. You're like, I'm on, like, my third agent by now.
Second.
Did you kind of freak out? Did you think, that's it? I'm going to be, like, the next Britney Spears.
Yeah.
Like, overnight, right? Like, you think that this is going to be so easy. I've just been discovered. What about you? How did you meet her agent?
I met her agent through her.
Yeah.
I kind of, like, we did a lot of shows before this, before I had an agent.
What kind of shows?
I did a lot of shows before with one of my friends.
Yeah.
It was very fun just performing.
Like
really
where? Like
it.
On stage, you mean?
Yeah.
Or like, yeah? Like in schools? Or?
Oh, well, I do the talent show at school.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what are you doing?
Well, I was just singing. And this year, I'm going to do a duo with my friend. He's going to beatbox.
Yeah.
Well,
I'm going to sing.
Yeah, it's going to be really
fun. He's going to beatbox?
Yeah.
And you're going to sing?
Yeah.
Wow. Does this beatboxer, do they share your agent too? So this woman hands you a card, and what do you do next?
My dad, like, he actually showed my mom, and we had an interview with the people, and they wanted me on their roster.
Yeah.
And I think a couple weeks later, I got, like, an Olympian commercial.
Right.
And I was really excited.
You were with the Olympians?
No.
No. They kind of edited that.
Yeah.
Were you singing at that time? Or did you want to sing?
I did musical theater camps in the summer.
Yeah. Did you like it?
Yeah, I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then how do you find out about the Mini Pops?
I used to listen to them when I was younger, and we would always see their commercials.
Yeah.
And actually, I've auditioned 3 times. Same with Avery. We auditioned at the same time the first year.
Right.
And I just wanted to go keep on trying, get myself out there.
So you didn't make it the first 2 times?
Yeah.
Wow. Does that kill you inside? Like, does that make you
I was
sad?
Disappointed.
Do you look at everybody else and say, like, I'm so much
No. No. Yeah. Like, the kids that got it, like, last year and the year before, I totally can see why they got it. And right. It just takes some progress.
You know, it's all hard work, you know?
Yeah.
It's all hard work.
And I would imagine, like, for when you're that age, when you're your age, not when you're that age, when you're, like, 2 years younger, like, it's sad. Because you realize that there's people that make it, and sometimes there's people that don't. And I mean, adults can't handle rejection most of the time. I can only imagine what it's like as a kid. Like, do your parents walk you to audition?
I knew to keep on trying, because that's just what, like, the industry, you just need to keep on networking, and someday you will get there.
Yeah.
But I just knew to keep on trying, and one day I'll hopefully get it.
Right. So so you both tried it. So when did you try out for this edition of Mini Pops? How long ago was that?
Start of the summer.
In the summertime?
Yeah.
Wow. And what did you have to do for your audition?
Self-tape.
Okay. And what did you do?
Oh, we sang a song.
And what song did you sing?
What did I sing? I sang this song called Where's the Love by Black Eyed Peas.
Yeah. And then what did you do?
I did You Smile by Justin Bieber.
Right. does the gang sign language there? And so realistically, so then you send in the tape, and then who calls you back?
Did you get an email?
We got an email.
Yeah.
Got an email. And then are there like 20? Are there a lot more kids out there?
There
was the first
600 people.
600?
Yeah.
How many people applied? Do you know? Or did 600 people send in their
kids? 600.
And, wow. And how many kids are there now?
Eight.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's like you won. Like, even before you step on stage, you're like, that's it. And then where do you go from there? Do you start picking songs, or the songs picked for you?
Like, 2 weeks after, we started, like, recording.
Yeah.
Yeah, we started recording.
And did you know each other? Like, did you know?
From the audition.
Yeah. And did you hang out at all at, like, people's houses and say, that's it, we're going to go through this together?
Yeah, we're really close as a group. We're really close.
Yeah.
Well, at the start, we were kind of like, should we go talk to them? Or like,
it was really boys in the corner, girls in the other.
Welcome to the world. Yeah, get used to that. That's going to be every party that you ever go to in your life. Who's that social one then, that from the other side that goes and walks up to the girls or to the boys? Who's
from
the
yours,
one?
From yours,
Eliseo's
the...
Yeah. And then, so during your rehearsals, because it's not just singing, you're not just up there with microphones, you're singing and dancing at the same time.
Yeah.
Is there one that you like to do more than the other?
I've been dancing for 6 years,
okay.
So that's more my comfort zone, but I really love singing, and I'm starting to get a passion for it.
That's hard to do. It's hard to sing and dance at the same time.
Yeah.
And that's why you see so many people lip syncing, because they just, but you guys don't.
No,
there's no lip syncing whatsoever.
Yeah.
Live band, usually.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so.
A track.
Right. Okay. Right. And then, what's been the best moment? So you're going on tour, very very shortly.
Yes.
What's the best moment so far being a Mini Pop kid?
Moment so far being a Mini Pop kid is probably performing on stage and doing what I love, because, you know, my quote is like, I say this to everybody: love what you do and do what you love. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's your quote. That's amazing. That's like your mantra of life. That's like a business card. That's amazing. I don't even have a quote, and I'm like pushing 50. And so, what's your best moment?
My best moment is I love camera work and everything, and I love meeting fans and just seeing like yourself build as a person, I would say, or just a confidence level, because I wasn't that confident before I got into Mini Pop Kids. Because, I'm still bullied at school, but I just know that I always have people at Mini Pop Kids that will support me.
Yeah.
And I just love meeting hair and makeup. I love getting
You know, me too. You know, I like the makeup.
Oh, yeah. Okay,
so,
does guys makeup.
So go back to the bullying part, because I would imagine that there's probably a lot of your friends are really supportive. They're really, really happy.
Yeah.
But then there's probably a lot of jealousy happening in your school, where you're just like, you ain't all that.
Yeah.
Well,
how do you handle that?
What I would say is just ignore it. You know, it's not going to change unless you just ignore it. They'll eventually stop if you ignore it,
Yeah. you ever go to her school and like, you know, start wanting to like beat up the other kids?
Oh, you don't even know.
And I would imagine that, you know, when I saw you guys in the summertime, you were doing a benefit, and you were singing a song that all the proceeds are going to the Hospital for Sick Kids.
Oh, yeah.
That's got to be really cool to look out in the audience and see. Because when I was in the back, there were a whole bunch of kids that just looked up to you that may have seen you for the very first time.
Yeah.
And they're like, that's what I want to do. Like, yeah. That's so cool that you're being these stars to these kids.
Yeah.
And parents who are like, oh, I should have done that.
Yeah, I get some messages on my social media saying from their parents saying, like, you inspire my kid. And, you know, I give a couple shout-outs sometimes.
Yeah. And you probably make somebody's day doing that.
And it's nice to give back, too.
Yeah.
Because before this, we weren't Winnipeg kids. We were just normal kids. And
But that's interesting, though, because, like, you're still the same people. But, like, everything else changes around you.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, going back to, like, these people in your school, like, you haven't changed. They did. They're the ones that see you differently.
Yeah.
And so are you, when you look at all the tour days, you're playing, like, 21, 22 times over the next couple of months. What are you really super excited about? That maybe not be on stage. Like, do you love the travel? Is staying at the hotel like the best part?
Yes, the hotel is my favorite part. But, you know, I don't really like traveling because I get the car sick and stuff. And this one time I was actually, like, I got car sick. We were going to Winnipeg.
Right.
And, like, you can't see a thing. So my dad had to pull over and stop the car.
Yeah.
And, like, I almost got lost.
Why couldn't you see a thing? Like,
it was, like, snowing and
all that stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
I had to go outside with a t-shirt on. It was snowing. And throw up.
Do your thing. Yeah, do your thing. Yeah.
And that's the best part so far of what you're
doing. Yeah, you know?
So Winnipeg, if he's looking a little bit ill, don't have snow. What are you looking forward to?
Well, traveling, I'm kind of used to because my dad's actually a pilot.
Wow.
So
why aren't you taking a plane to all these places?
We are.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Is he flying?
No.
That's
no,
gotta
it's,
be
it's
so cool
his.
If it was, right?
Yeah.
Like, this is your captain speaking. Does he drive his father? Yeah. You know, today's in flight entertainment will be my daughter. So what can people expect to see for people who might have grown up with the Mini Pops? If I get a ticket, what am I gonna check out?
You're gonna see some singing to 24 hit songs. Dancing.
Yeah.
Entertainment.
Your favorite songs there.
Yeah. And it's all clean too.
Yeah.
That's still amazing. Cause I remember growing up, it was like the Mini Pops. It was all the clean version of the song so that the parents can enjoy
it's
and
family
love.
Family.
Yeah. And then, what's the last? You know what, like, and just in looking at you both, like, I got like 1,000 questions. When's the last time that you guys made each other laugh so hard that you cried?
Oh my god.
Oh, see, I should have asked this first. Okay. This is where the real nitty gritty is gonna,
like,
come in.
In Niagara Falls?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So we're in like a hotel. I don't know how, Jazzy just started randomly laughing.
I couldn't stop laughing and my
what
laugh.
What were you laughing at?
I don't even know.
I think I was tired or something. Too much candy. We just got back from the arcade a big dinner.
Yeah.
And my laugh literally gets everyone in the group. Literally, we were at the YouTube space filming challenges.
I
start laughing. Everyone, even the camera guys, you could hear them, like, laughing. And it was so funny.
One down. In looking at the videos, they're so fun. And you can't fake that. So it's got to be a really great time.
Yeah, we actually did one of our music videos on a private jet.
Yeah.
High Hopes. It's coming out soon. You know, stay tuned for that.
What song is it for?
High Hopes. Coming out on Friday.
Is your dad on that plane?
He arranged it. He arranged it.
You got a discount on that.
He arranged it.
Wow. People that have connections like that, it's going to be great. The brand new album is out now, and you go to minipopkids.com for all the details on their nationwide tour that starts very, very shortly. from now, and you can hear them sing some of the biggest songs that are all clean version by Ariana Grande, Maroon 5, and Bruno Mars. You love these people, too.
Oh, my gosh.
It helps that. Like, who's your favorite artist now?
My favorite artist is probably Bruno Mars, because I love the way he performs, sings.
Yeah.
You know, he's just an inspiration. You know, you can go.
And who do you love now?
I love Bruno Mars, yes.
Yeah.
And Khalid. And I met him at the Jingle Ball.
Yeah.
I was starstruck. I was freaking out.
Did you tell him who you were?
No, but he said, I like your bag.
when these people, like, when you get to meet these people, do you say, like, I'm a mini pop? Like, do you get to say that?
Well, like, Jamie Fine and, like, some other people, we
said
that, like, we were mini pop kids.
Yeah.
And they knew what we were talking about.
Right, because I'm telling you, we all grew up with that in our lives. And
yes.
You are the next generation of it. So it's a big mantle to have. It's a big responsibility, you two. You know, we're all going to be looking out for it. So you can go to minipopkid.com for all the details. Hey, Payne and Jazzy, thanks so much for joining me today. Appreciate
it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great. Beautiful.
That was amazing.
Good job, guys.
Awesome.